Brandon Gaughan, Charles Davis, ready for this ultimate team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players.
Oh, great. I haven't played for a while. Let's get the party started. Now, this could be pretty bad. Well, it depends who else is on his team. But it doesn't look too good for right now.
Set to go now on a beautiful sunny
bad afternoon. Thing about not playing for a while. Kind of behind.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22.
All right, here we go. All right.
They go play action here on first down. He completes it to Julio Jones. That he's brought down.
Dang it.
Give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually
all right, here we go.
One?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Dang it! Use the same exact frickin' play. Come on.
It's a big one there for the Vikings. And even 50 yards.
While sometimes it doesn't appear like much, the out route can be very dangerous when you throw it to a guy like Julio Jones. If you try and undercut it, he can turn into a big play. The reason he's able to get it so often is because of his ability to push people deep, and they have to respect that.
Brady now on first down. That is caught at the 7-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up a second and goal. Brady to throw again. And too much on that one. It's out of the back of the end zone, incomplete.
Come on. Need something.
Can this defense get the stop on the opening drive? Here's third and goal. In motion, the tight end Reed. Brady now on third and goal. And that is
yes.
Incomplete. Whew. Jordan Reed was the intended target, and it brings up fourth down. Now Justin Tucker's out to try the field goal. This just a 24-yard attempt.
And that was a nice play. He knocked it away, but obviously you want
at least I stopped him to a field goal.
Any chance they have any decision to make on
I better be careful passing my receivers. He has Sherman on his team.
Compressed area of the field that you're just happy to knock it away and not allow a touchdown.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard
line. All right. Do it. Well, that was terrible blocking.
Lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. On second down, Wilson.
I screwed that up. I did not want to pass today. I was like torn between B and A, and I just tapped A. Oops.
And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
On
second down, here's Brady. And now a fumble. Ah. Dang it. Viking was able to corral this one in Minnesota with deep possession.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
So the offense able to recover the fumble, but it's third down now. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Left side here to Sanders.
There we go.
And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Call it a gain of three. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This from 54 yards away.
Yeah. Nice. And this score will yeah. Missed. That's perfect. Yeah.
Darn upright getting in the way.
Always gets in the way of a good time, doesn't it? Because he hit it square, too. Sometimes you can bank one in if you get it on the football. No such luck there for him.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
On second down, here's Wilson. And Daniels has it over the
ice.
Middle. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right now he knew right away.
Picked that too quick. I don't want to run that.
The one running back is Gurley. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. And Daniels has it left side. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second.
I don't really want to run that too much. That is pretty cheap.
Just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays. Makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Play action. Now Wilson. He's just going to dump this one off to his
front. Nice. Yeah.
Pick up there, 26 yards.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
On first down, it's Gurley. Shrugs the tackle.
Oh! Nice! Yeah! Todd Gurley, baby!
Todd Gurley, a 10-yard touchdown run. And once again, the Patriots are back out in front. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And now out comes Minnesota. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their
game. Yeah.
But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if
less of a field goal. Well, hopefully I can get through this game.
Complete pass brings up second down. Ready to throw on second down. Green's got it over. 12 yards.
Darn it.
They move the chains.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down.
Nice.
To perfection. He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time.
Jeez, he has Julio Jones and A.J. Green. My goodness. I'd love to have both of those guys on my team.
That's exactly right. For as much as he throws, doesn't take a lot of square shots, but took one there.
He's really
smart. Yeah!
Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Lawrence Timmons. And his these guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before. They have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. A one-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Wilson. Oh, he got me there.
Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. And now out comes Minnesota. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. It's just
a 50-yard. Yeah, baby!
Picked off by Nickel Roby. And a big turnover there.
This is not good, though. I'm like right on the yard line. Oh boy.
Onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He'll just tell us before every.
Oh, he's not going to make it to the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. So this is where a defense can really pin back its ears, bring it all, sell out to stop the run. This time, it'll earn them 2 points.
Well, that did not work out for me.
One blitz all the way, and that's a bad feeling for a running back when he knows he's got to at least get it over the goal line. But all he sees are opposing jerseys.
So after the INT, it's Brady. And this is going to be caught? No, they say it's incomplete.
Out routes are always timing routes. And if the timing's off just a little bit, it can really throw off a play. It looked like he led him a little too much there.
Yeah, there was a fraction of a second because he caught it, just couldn't stay in bounds. Brady again here on second and 10. And it's incomplete. He was hoping to get that one to take
Coleman
in space. And it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. To throw is Brady. And able to find Brady. It's a gain of 5.
Dang it.
And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
Nice. Yeah. Yeah.
Able to run him down for a loss of 12. On second down, here's Brady. He's got
a come on.
And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll make it second down. He had time, was able to survey the field, and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. 15 yards through the air on a first down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up and making sure it was a catch.
Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here.
On. Need to stop here.
It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Again, it's Brady. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. In motion, the tight end Reed. Brady going to try and throw on third down.
Yes!
There he goes, right side. A great read, and it's picked off. The 40.
Right before freaking halftime.
And he takes this one back into the end zone.
Yeah, that must make him freaking sick after seeing that, man. Oh, ho, ho, ho.
Anticipation on the play.
I'd be so freaking mad right now. And I get the ball too. Oh, I'd be so mad right now. God dang it. Freaking. Ugh. Dang it.
And he'll make it across the 20 as those guys will set up shop at the
23-yard line.
The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They have the lead now.
That was pretty good, but I had to get some recording in before I continued playing, so I'm right now playing some Madden online. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this guy's probably sick right now. He was on the goal line. He was going for a touchdown. I intercepted it for a touchdown from the goal line. I returned it all the way back. It'll make this guy sick. Plus, Well, what happened? I ran it the whole entire field. I intercepted it before halftime. Now I got the ball back. So he's probably jacked right now. The driving. I think the driving's actually worse than.
So second and eight here after.
I don't know. I kind of like the first one actually better than the second one. The driving.
Now Wilson on second down. It's caught by Mike Evans. It goes as a gain of eight and moves
what?
The chains. When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to
hit
him because if he's able to
like the little puzzle thing,
he can hurt you downfield. He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Yeah. Huh. Probably sooner get used to the buttons sooner as play it more often.
Escaping the pressure right. And his pass incomplete. Evans, the one he was looking for. And that takes us from second to third down.
I know we're doing this game live, but let's step into the film room
for
just a second. Because when they review this play, oh, the negatives are going to be incredible on this one. Rolling out to his right. Yeah, his right hand, it's a natural spot for him.
Oh, is it that, is it the, create your ball thing?
Big no-no.
Oh, that's a monster no-no. The only good thing that happened, it fell incomplete. Very fortunate.
So, is the game much better with the mods, you think?
This is going to work out well as it's out of bounds near the 13-yard line. It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half? Because
did you get any farther in that, or did you try Nuka World out yet?
And go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
Coleman. And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. A 6-yard pickup on the ground that time, and that'll make it 3rd and 4 coming up. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They stay on the ground.
Oh, I was wondering. I didn't remember fetching candy in Fallout.
It's a gain of just 3, and the offense likely going to yield to the punting unit here on 4th down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can't believe it's a day I didn't fall asleep.
Territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on 4th and a yard. They'll run it with Coleman. And he is going to lose yardage here.
Huh. Okay. Bye. Sorry. Sorry, guys. This my brother called here. My offense definitely deteriorates when I talk. So, but my defense has done pretty well. So, especially that halftime interception. I'd be so sick after that. Well, he quit. How about that? Wow. Okay. I didn't realize my defense was that good. Huh. Alright. Awesome.